I'm sorry. I'm Timoteo, and this is another installment of the Eagle Eye Report. But first, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I'm gonna need a little help. Anyone? Miss Tisa, please?
Sure. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Miss Tisa.
De nada.
Attention East High School, and all of the fellow students who are so talented. The Ebony Culture Club will be holding auditions Tuesday, April 22nd and April 24th, which is a Thursday, at 2:15 in the East Auditorium. Auditions can only be 1 to 3 minutes long, please. Auditions with inappropriate language or behavior will not be tolerated. The talent show is Thursday, May 1st at 2:15 in the auditorium. Interested in a career in cosmetology? Are you entering the 11th grade next year? You must be on track with your credits towards graduation, and you must have your school counselor approval before participating. A parent-student information night is Wednesday, April 23rd, to 6 to 7 p.m. at Rochester's Educational Opportunity Center, 161 Chestnut Street. Now for a special report. Given the school-wide concern about the state's decision to change East High School, we hit the halls to investigate. Here's what we found.
When we talk about East High School, you know, we are often associated with the best city school in the Rochester City School District. I don't deny that. I strongly believe that everything needs to stay the same about East High School. For several reasons. One, we have the best school in the Rochester City School System. It's been proven. We have several magnet programs that actually help students. We have the TLI program, the Teaching and Learning Institute, our IT department, our optics program, our culinary institute. All those things help students choose a career. And by choosing a career, we can go forth with our future. It's not like we have to choose one. We can choose multiple. Our athletics are the best, not only in the city, but in the county. Okay, when you think about East High School, you think of all the awards we have. We have a whole hallway of awards. Everything basically needs to be the same, because East High is not only a legacy, it is the truth.
And then it's the same as the way, not the way it's being run, but more than likely the name, the legacy, the way things are, have been and have been, because, you know what I'm saying, since 7th grade I've grown up here. It's a good school. Everything just needs to be stayed the same, except for they just need to do more about kids not wanting to do work and other things. Well, for one, the administration, and I feel like there need to be more small learning communities in the school and more of different programs such as BOCES, to where kids can learn a trade or a skill than actually going to college, because college is clearly not meant for anybody financially or physically.
One thing that I think should be changed at East is like the kids fighting over it. Most of all, this prevents more fighting, doesn't make anything better for the school. And then some teachers don't even care for what happens for some students. They just go about their business and stuff like that. And make some more programs that could be helpful for some students, because some students, we don't have everything. We want to have some things that can help every student, because some might not, know what they want to do yet until they most likely get into a program, and the people they hang out with, or people they talk to, and the teachers.
Now for your words of wisdom. So what does it mean to be a successful human being? There are probably as many different definitions as there are human beings in the world. Listen to this definition from world-famous cultural anthropologist Margaret Mead, She says, I must admit that I personally measure success in terms of the contributions an individual makes to his or her fellow human beings. Notice she didn't say anything about money or power or material possessions making a person successful. Today, ask yourself this: what contributions do I make to my family, my school, my community? Your answer could be the measure of your own success. We got the power to change the world, Isai. Let's get to work.
I'm sleeping and right in the middle of a good dream. Like all at once I wake up from something that keeps knocking at my brain. Before I go insane, I hold my pillow to my head and spring up in my bed, screaming out the words I dread. I think I love you.